Hello there everybody, how's it going? I'm Void and I'm here doing League of Legends commentary today, and today I am playing as Shaco in the jungle, classic Shaco in the classic lane, and we're gonna make some good things happen in this world, hopefully. This is just a theory, it's very possible no good things will happen, and then we'll just feed horribly and be very sad about the whole situation, but, you know, that's perfectly fine. We're gonna go start our Gromp, suppose. It looks like they have a Teemo jungle. So that's a pretty interesting thing. I'm not sure how to feel about it, but that's okay. What's the duration on these thingamabobs? It's lasts for 60 seconds, so I do want to start putting them down right now. And I can try taking the Teemo's red, though I'm honestly unsure how well that would go. I'm very inexperienced when it comes to Shaco, so it's hard to really say. I did forget to say the team, so I'll go over that quickly. We have Warwick top, Blitzcrank support, Shaco jungle as your mid, close to AD carry. I should make sure to put my boxes down. They have Blitzcrank support, Teemo jungle, Kog'Maw AD carry, Lulu top, and Talon mid. So again, I can try to do something to this Teemo, but I'm unsure if he'll really do anything. I'm going to say no, just so they're aware they don't need to be here. And that will be the end of that. Blitzcrank, I hope you aren't going to be a scumbag and like try to take anything here, because that would kind of disappoint me. I'm not going to smite. That way I can save the smite for maybe taking the Teemo's thingy. So we're going to place a ward right here, and I'm going to go kind of around the beaten path here, because it's possible they might have warded the Tribush. We don't know. Alright, so we see where the Teemo is. That's something to keep in mind. We also saw where the Teemo went, so I'm gonna have to like time this kind of randomly, but I think I'll be able to pull this off. So we're gonna go ahead and do some damages here, and that should not be a kill, but it will cause him to have to go back. If I can get another crit auto off, then I could have gotten a kill, but sadly that will not be happening. But we will go and throw an ignite on him right there, and another auto here, because for some reason he wanted to walk back into me, which will let me get a kill. Problem is, now I'm pretty low on health, and I'm not really in a position to where I feel comfortable trying to steal this, so I'm just gonna go ahead and leave. You know, that was a pretty sloppy way that went down, but we still, you know, came out on top, so it's not that bad. I think what I'm gonna do is go to my red buff and get that, because of the fact that I'm not entirely sure if I can actually take the blue effectively. So, you know, we're just gonna go ahead and not do anything of the sort. But getting a first blood there is, of course, very useful, and I'm pretty happy about it. So, I think I can get this this red buff relatively easily. I'm pretty sure the smite will mostly carry me through allowing me to get it, but that's fine by me. Just waiting, you know, until we're as low as possible before we actually do smite it. That wasn't as low as possible, but that's okay. Place a little box right there. Let's, you know, do a little bit more damage just that much quicker. And now we will probably go back, because I don't want to take any chances. And by go back now, I mean go get our blue, because we might, I'm pretty sure we can get it, actually, with the amount of health we have. We have another slight tick. We won't get the health bonus, but I don't really think we need it. Teemo, I doubt Teemo's going to be trying to try to take it. All right, we're good. Place a box right here. Nice little knife fan, flippantastic. And work on getting this blue buff nice and easy. I am going to smite it. Actually, it doesn't really matter when I smite it, but yeah, this will be an easy buff for me. So we got our buffs pretty, you know, nicely. Problem is, of course, my knight's down for, you know, a gank, but at the end of the day, you don't really need your knight. It's nice to have your knight early, of course, but at the end of the day, if your knight gets a kill and you're going Shaco Ignite, it's not that bad. So we're going to go back here and pick ourselves a... I do like Stalker's Blade. I know some people like to go Skirmisher Saber on Shaco, but I'm going to pass, and we're going to go ahead and go for the Warriors. I could potentially go Devourer. I actually used to go Pharaoh Flare on Shaco because I thought it was pretty good on him, because it actually made his late game a lot better, but I'm not going to do that here. I'm just going to go maybe for complete early game dominance, especially considering that they have a Kog'Maw, Talon, and Lulu. They have a lot of people that are very easy to assassinate, so that's pretty much what I'm going to be banking on. So we'll work on getting these Raptors here, smite it for the bonus, and I'm actually going to do a little bit of invisible here for the crit chance as well. Not the crit chance, it's actually a guaranteed crit. So technically my terminology is incorrect, and I apologize. And are you okay there, Mr. Warwick? You look like you're in a little bit of a situation here. He's not gonna die, but that was definitely... No, he has seen better days, and we're gonna place a box box right here. I don't know if it'll trigger... If the risk cutter will trigger it. The risk cutter will not trigger it. But this looks like potential here. Ah, he looks... He seems worried. He seems really worried, and that's gonna be a dead Warwick up there. This guy's not gonna take any chances. Oh, what the heck, we'll just go in here. Won't be able to do any damages, but, well, won't be able to kill him, but that's okay by me. We'll just go and work on getting as much damage as we can and let our boxes kind of defend us properly and throw a knife at him just to show him how I feel about life. And all the Azirs now here. Looks like he went over to his blue buff, which is still up as well. So we're being a very big nuisance to this Teemo and, you know, making sure he cannot get his buffs easily, which is fine by me. But I'm also in a problem that, you know, most Shacos run into this problem where you get really far behind on XP really quickly. Like, I'm level 3 and Lulu's 6. So because of that, I should definitely take some time to just start killing some camps. Because if I keep trying to gank and nothing actually comes out of it, that's not going to be very good for us. So we're going to get the Rift Scuttler. And then probably just get this here Gromp next, and that will be fantastic. Arguably, I should go for the Wolves because I'm not as strong, because I haven't killed them yet. But, you know, that's okay by me. I do have my Ignite up again, so I definitely do want to, you know, throw Gank off and, you know, somewhere relatively soon, if at all possible. It's just as of right now, I don't really see a good opportunity to gank. Talon is kind of open, but he's not really open enough, so I think I'll just pass. And they did get their blue. I'm assuming Teemo's going to go Devourer. That's generally what Teemo junglers do, is they go the attack speed item. They mob. So, you know, with red buff, that will result in some pretty shifty things. I don't know why I did that there. That was, like, very old school. Like, no one does that anymore. That just makes me come extremely lame, and I apologize. But, to be fair, it is also very accurate for me to be lame. So the Warwick going to try to do a level 6 roam, but I don't know how well it's going to work out considering how far talent is there. Oh, and the talent actually went a little bit all in there, so we'll try our best. There's that, and we did get the kill. I didn't want to take any chances, and oh, he barely died. That's a shame. All right, I don't think it's possible Azir was going to get the kill there, but in a situation like that, like, don't take any chances. I mean, I can understand laying someone with Ignite get the kill. In fact, you should let someone with Ignite get the kill if you know their flash is down and they're like running away from you with like 50 health. You should let them get the kill there. But in that situation, you know, I'm not taking any gosh dang risks. Also, it looks like bot lane's having a little bit of a debacle down there. Kalista didn't die, but an Ignite was used on her, which is pretty nice. And Warwick did not actually use her ultimate, but his health is also, you know, it's seen better days. But that will not stop me from ganking still. Oh, nope, she's staying. So I guess I'll try to do everything I can here. There's the knife, and we're going to keep doing as much as we can. And there's the ignite on her. She will die, but I cannot do enough to really save the Warwick there, which is a shame. He wanted to go in on that. And, like, I was hesitant because I knew Warwick was going to die if we, you know, went all in there. But I'll wait, actually. And we already started. I was going to say I should have, you know, just gone for the red buff there, but that's okay. And Yazir, you're not having a very great time against Talon, but I can definitely see why Talon would, you know, have a favorable matchup against Azir, especially considering our Azir's going Gnasher's Tooth, which, as we all know, is kind of, you know, not too great. It's possible they're doing early dragon. They might be doing drag. I'm not really in a position to, you know, check right now, but considering their bot lane's Mia, Talon's going that direction. I don't know where Teemo is. It wouldn't surprise me if that's what they're, you know, accomplishing. But we'll find out soon from the giant dragon roar if it shows up. If it doesn't show up, then that's good for us. But, you know, only time will tell. I'm also going to place a Bex right here just in case anyone chooses to invade that area, which is unlikely, but you never know. Alright. So Warwick is probably the easiest target for us to gank, simply because as long as he ults, we can probably get a kill. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go Berserker's Greaves, because I do want some attack speed. It'd be nice so I can apply my red buff just that much more. And we have Teemo in his red buff area. So we know that Teemo's low on health, which means if we see his blue buff come up again, that is potentially very good for us. We know Warwick's ultimate's going to be up very soon, so I'm going to immediately head up there. And then as soon as it's up, we are going to be on top of it. Going to paint that on my way. His ultimate is now up. And Mai is up as well, and I do have the smite proc this time, and I had it last time, I just didn't use it. Let's see here. There's the invisible. We got it off, and there's the ultimate from the Warwick. We'll go and do as much damage as we can, and this should be a kill, nice and easy. Looks like Warwick just wants me to get it, which is fine by me. Another kill, and another fantastic Shaco gank, which has proven to be quite successful. I don't know why these minions are so adamant about following me, but that's okay. Just put a little box right there on the off chance Talon's showing up. Great, I didn't see him. Alright, there's the ward. So I'm going to paint that he should be careful, but he is also at full health, so I think he'll be okay. But you never know, he might still choose to show up. Yeah, there he is. He should definitely be wary there, Mr. Warwick. I was not heeding a warning, a mistake possibly. It's looking likely. Will he be able to live? Warwick, yeah, he just like healed through it. Alright then, well that'll be the end of that. Oh no, ooh. Warwick did almost die at the end of the day, but he lived, so that's okay. And I am going to save my smite tick because of the fact that it seems, you know, useful in this situation. I see a Teemo here, so we're going to do our best to maybe get some damages here and then immediately do a little bit of shifty plays here, and I might die. I did die. There was a gosh dang Lulu bottom. I was not expecting that. I'm assuming she teleported, and I just didn't realize it. That was extremely, extremely unexpected to see a Lulu bottom. Alright then. And now Azir will also die for putting himself in a stupid position. It's a shame. And it may sound a bit rude, you know, stupid. Unfavorable position, we'll call it. I mean, it's, you know, it's one of the situations where it's like, well, I don't want to say stupid because it comes off as rude, but, you know, would anyone disagree that he shouldn't have been there? Probably not. But to be fair, I also put myself in a bad position. And that will be a dragon because of that, which is not exactly ideal. In fact, I'm pretty much composed of all the kills in our team, and Azir is composed of most of the deaths. But at least we have a Callista who is doing some good things in this world. So I'm going to go ahead and just head over to this Talon here and probably could pick up a kill. That'll be extremely easy, and I will just watch him burn to death. So very ideal. And I'm not even sure if I had to use my Ignite there. But, you know, what the heck, we'll use it anyway. I am going to level up my Q next. I think because it decreases the cooldown, or it increases, yeah, it increases the crit damage that it'll do, which, you know, for the initial damage is quite good. I'm not going to, you know, do it over my W, though, or over my E, I should say, simply because the E is, like, your only other source of damage when you're not just autoing somebody. So, you know, and again, I'm not going to use my smite on this buddy. And he's not my buddy, he's actually just a giant poisonous frog. But I'm not going to use my smite on him because I really want to save that for ganks. And I don't see any opportunity to gank right now, which of course is Shaco. I'm always looking for any possible opportunity. But Warwick's ultimate's up, and Lulu will likely be pushing soon. So I'll probably head up there now that I know Warwick's in a position where I can gank him again. Love our E to its maximum capability. And it's doing a pretty good amount of base damage by itself. So that's pretty good, and I believe it does more damage when you hit them from behind. I think that could be incorrect, but that's okay. Azir's going to be heading back in the middle lane. I'm going to go throw a gank at this Warwick once again and see what we can get out of this. How aware are they? He might have made it. I don't know if she is awarded. I should definitely get my sweeper lens. That way I know if I can sit in a bush like that or not. But I think instead what I'm going to do is I'm going to walk on over to one of these bushes and see if I can do a little bit of a lane gank here. So we're going to sit in here for a little bit, wait for all cooldown to come off, put a box here to pass the time, and I'm going to go ping relatively soon. I'm going to ping her and go invisible here, and this should be a kill, I think. There's the Warwick ultimate. We'll just keep on autoing, and up. He's gonna die. She's gonna die. We're gonna throw a knife at him. The frame rate even decided to just go crazy because of how intense that was. But that will be the end of that. Another very easy gank on the Lulu, the Shaco Warwick synergy. It's probably very annoying how she can't really deal with it. And no one likes lane ganks either. That's not good. A fed Kog'Ma in the early game. Never something that really should happen, but it's happened because of the Talon roam, so that's concerning, definitely. I don't really know how good Teemo's been doing his farm. So at least there's that. Our blue buff won't be up for a decent amount of time. I'm definitely not going to give blue to Azir because I definitely do not trust him with it. Plain and simple. As much as I would like to tell you that maybe I should trust him, I just can't. Especially because he's... I mean, it's not necessarily that it's all his fault. Again, Talon's a very not so ideal matchup for Azir, so I can't really blame him that much, but you know. I'm gonna place a box right there, just in case, that way I can kind of like see him if he chooses to go to the wolves. And I'm also gonna steal his grump, because why the heck not, you know, we can deny him some devour stacks, which is always ideal. And there is a Lulu up there again. Warwick's ultimate's not up though, but he does seem like he wants to do something here, so we'll try. But it's risky, because I know there's a town nearby, and now I'm immediately going to depart because the town's on the way. It's just a matter of if we can escape in time now. I need to keep a very close eye to for if I see his ultimate shards. That's just a glitch, so I don't need to worry about that. I'm going to go really far back just to play it safe. Put a box where I'm going to recall. That way, if he chooses to go on me, he's in for a pleasant surprise. Hello. You are really all about this Blitzcrank, aren't you, buddy? You really should just leave and get out, because I do not like your company. Thank you very much. Going to go really up against the wall and go back. Warwick should get back in time to stop the turret from dying. I just don't want to take any chances considering who I just saw. And it suggests Hydra. I will go Hydra. I can really use some wave clear to make my minions go away faster, so that's what I'm going to do. You know, it's, when I was playing Kha'Zix earlier, that wasn't really necessary as much because of the fact that my missiles pretty much did the job. So there is that, and looks like Blitzcrank never actually left. Warwick might get a kill anyway, but the pull will interrupt the Warwick, and there's also a Teemo here. So that was a lot of people to finish off the Warwick, who was, you know, it was kind of interesting how they chose to devote that many resources to the Warwick when there's all the stuff going on in the bottom lane. Hello there, Teemo. Was not expecting your presence nearby. I will just go and push this lane pretty rapidly because I do, you know, prefer my turret, or my DAP turret is in decent health. Even, you know, technically it's not my turret. You can say it's technically belongs to someone that isn't me, but that's okay. Blitzcrank definitely should not have recalled. He definitely should have stopped this mid turret from dying, because he easily could have just by showing up and silencing the town. I don't know why he didn't, but you know what, people make interesting decisions. I'm going to smite this for the vision benefit, and I would like to go get this Rift Scudder now, if at all possible. So let's see if we can go acquire that, because dragging me up 15 seconds, pretty important objective, you know, and I will immediately go and dispose of this ward. So nice and easy, there we go. You know, he has two more charges by the looks of it, but might as well do it anyway. Hopefully we don't have to use Smite to get the Swift Scudder. Doesn't look like we'll have to, so that will be benefiting to us. And that will be the Rift Scudder, nice and easy. Oh, Teemo going the Ruan's build, and he's getting near his Say Devourer. Teemo has actually only died once. Oh, Azir got blue. I'm not sure how I feel. Ooh, good pull off on the Blitzcrank. Very good pull, actually. You know what, Teemo? You can do all you want, but that's not going to stop the fact that you are in a shifty situation here. So we're going to go ahead and do a lot of damage to this guy, and probably pick ourselves a kill relatively easily, so that'll just be the team at proc for the kill. And I think we're still fighting here. I don't really know if we should be. I would really just like to get the dragon. Okay, you know what? They can do that. Actually, I don't know if I can solo this. I'm pretty sure I can. I cannot solo this team, please. Somebody help me. Okay. Help. Alright, well, that's a thing. Lulu Flash will try to get us. She won't be able to get the dragon on her own, I don't think. Play this pro. Oh, what? That hit me. I can't believe that hit me. The dragon was behind her. And so that the glitter lands from that is what got me. That's extremely frustrating. Wow, I thought I was in the clear there, but to be fair, I should have just like used my Q to get away this way, but I got greedy. So that will be the dragon for them, probably, because our team decided they wanted to keep fighting rather than just get the objective, which upsets me, but you know what, that's how people roll. They see kills and they're like, you know what? Let's kill people, because long-term dragon benefits aren't nearly as useful. It sounds like I'm extremely, you know, up dying, you know, it's like, what the heck is wrong with these noobs? But to be fair, it's annoying, it's just annoying how often it happens. Like, the amount of times that people can just get an easy dragon, but choose to go for kills, like, one kill instead, is baffling to me. And that is exactly one of the circumstances where we trade like one kill for a dragon. So I don't agree with it. Also, I'm like the only one here who's fed, which is not exactly ideal either, but you know, hopefully it's not going to be that bad. Level up our clones once again and see if we can accomplish any tasks. We do know Woolworth's ultimate's up, so we're going to go ahead and do this thingamabob right here, and we should be able to kill him relatively easy now, so that will be a kill for the Woolworth. And I'm just going to go and use my ultimate here, which won't actually help me, but I'm not going to die from it, so maybe a bit unnecessary, but you know, that's fine by me. Looks like some kills for the Azir, which is always good that he's starting to, you know, get some good stuff. I hope my team's actually in an okay position there. I do plan to go Yomu's next because I would really like the movement speed benefit, and it's just an all-around good item on Shaco. So that's what we're going to go. And let's see. Buffs rotation. Red was just taken care of. Blue's going to be up, not up for quite a while. Maybe we can do something here unless our team just does it for us if that Azir can get the last key off. That seemed a bit late. I'm assuming it was on cooldown. I hope it was on cooldown, because, I mean, let's just say this Azir seems new. But that's okay, you know, he tried his best. He probably shouldn't have flashed when he didn't have his Q up anyway, though. That's in my opinion. Let's work on getting this guy, though, which will be a grand old experience for the whole family. We see a Talon and a Kog'Maw nearby, as well as a Blitzcrank, but I know Talon and Kog'Maw were just here, so I don't want to take any chance of doing anything shifty. We'll place a box right there. Blitzcrank did see it, because it was still visible for a moment there, and maybe if he pulls the Talon, but there's a Kog'Maw here. Problem is, they're very aware there's a Kog'Maw here, and it doesn't seem to matter that much in this circumstance, so that's not going to be a win for us. Blitzcrank went in there when he shouldn't have, and that's as simple as that. Azir still just has Nashers. They're now all going to be pushing the middle lane. Well, I can maybe assassinate this guy. Maybe. If I can get the first auto off, gag! I couldn't get it off. That upsets me. Alright, there's a Lulu pushing the mid lane right now. And as I just stated before, I'd rather, you know, keep objective safe than go for kills. So that's what I'm going to do, and, you know, ensure this middle turret does not go down. Do a little bit of a team at proc, which will... Well, not Team at Proc, it's now Ravenous Hydra. Don't know why I'm still referring it to the team at when I have Ravenous Hydra now, but that's okay. We're going to get our blue buff, and it's going to be a grand old time. And I'm going to smite this for the off chance we can spot them in our jungle. Doesn't look like it's going to be successful, though, but that's fine by me. Go ahead and go get this blue buff now. Oh, hello, friends. That's a lot of individuals right there, and I'm not sure how to feel about it. Oh, wait, they're killing this individual. That's okay. He's a very dead man, but, you know, we'll just go and throw an item now to the end of that. Probably should have assisted the Kale, or not the Kale, but, you know, I'm going to let one of them get the kill because I have enough kills. Blitzcrank gain it. You know, that's fine by me, to be honest, and I really want this blue buff, but it seems like I never can catch a break here. Alright, there's the wall. Did absolutely nothing as far as I'm aware. We're probably going to get a kill here. We'll just, get it there nice and easy, and that's also gonna be a Lulu immediately rocking off once she shows up, which is fine by me. Azir turret is gonna, you know, give us a little bit of a benefit here, and that will be a kill off on the Lulu, maybe. No, it will not, so we'll just go ahead and bail here. They do have the vision benefit on me, so Blitzcrank probably shouldn't have done that, considering Lulu's overgrowth is a spell that exists, but maybe he thought I had more damage than I actually did have. I'm not sure. Either way, we're gonna go back and get our Yomu's ghost play, and maybe that'll give us some, you know, good movement speed capabilities. So there we go. Yomu's has been acquired. Two procable items. Granted, you know, ones I won't be using as much. And next, I will probably go for IE, methinks. I could go like another lifesteal item. Ah, dear. Callisto, you're 1-6, baby. You gotta stop pushing alone when there's a Talon. Why don't people... Okay. Let's go. Void's lessons of the day. First off, you know, emphasize dragon. We've been through that. Another thing to keep in mind. What the heck? Who is in there where they can be warded? But yeah, don't constantly split push as a Callista when there's an assassin who can kill you really easily and has already done it. I'm just saying. Alright. So the Rift Scuttler is not up as of right now. But they'll undoubtedly get it. Oh wait, I just did get it. Derp. I have a very good memory, as you can see. Alone. Let's not go for you as much as I would like to. And get this good Gromp. Nice and easy. Hello, friends. We'll place a little bit of a box right there and try to stop him from dying, but we know very well that's not going to happen. I would, prefer not to take poke there, if at all possible. Alright, he went Frozen Mallet second. Interesting choices. People keep getting caught. I want to make sure I don't get pulled by the Blitzcrank here. Oh. What the world did you just do, Azir? He dashed into them. I think he didn't realize that it's the closest soldier to you that you actually, teleport to. Are you okay, Callista? I hope the answer is yes, because you don't look very healthy right now, that's all I'm saying. So we're gonna do our best to maybe pick up some kills here, but too risky to keep going here, so we're just gonna well, there's the flash, never mind then. Is Timo gonna keep pushing top? I don't know. He is not, so we are free to keep chasing this guy. Otherwise, I would have been tempted not to, and alright, there he is. There's the Timo doing wonderful things, and they did scare Dragon as well. Never mind, Azir's there, we can get our red buff. So Timo will do a decent amount of damage to it before he actually has to leave. So this will be the red buff for me, as per usual. Azir was able to get the Timo low. No surprise he couldn't kill him. Use the Hydra proc to kill this guy. Nice and easy. Couple more autos. Fan flippantastic. And the pull into the spear. Good stuff. Good stuff. Okay, so that's three dragons for them. Ooh, I should remove this. Nice and easy. Boop and bada bing. Very good. Okay, so their entire team is up aside from Timo. Yeah, Timo's going, he's going all out with that attack speed build, which doesn't surprise me. They don't really need a tank right now because our team's getting caught out anyway. And when you that's the thing. You don't want to be in a position where you can get caught out. Hello. Good thing you were invisible there. I definitely did not want to fight that for that very reason. Alright. How is this going to end up? Not good by the looks of it, which doesn't surprise me. Okay. What in the world? I think Talon crit me? That were did he just do more damage than I suspected, which is very possible considering his build. Well, what are you gonna do, I suppose? I would like to tell you what Warwick's doing, but I simply don't have an answer. Okay. Azir, why did you keep walking forward? You should have immediately ran as soon as you got that kill. Alright, everyone's dead. That was my first death in a while. And the only one with a positive KDA. What do I... Probably just go for a BF sword now. That's gonna be Baron buff for them, though. Not exactly very, good. I'm never really in a position to where I can secure these objectives, which really does suck. And if I was anywhere nearby, I would be able to kill probably all three of them. But they will just kill the thing too dang fast, and that will be the end of that. Blitzcrank seems like he's gonna try to do something. But probably, he might succeed in getting Kog'Maw, but seems unlikely. That will be the ultimate. He got the Kog'Maw, that's good. Maybe we can do something here as well. It's possible. He put the Ignite off on the Blitzcrank, but that probably won't actually result in anything else, so we'll just take the time to push the lane. There we go. There's too many targets that I need to focus on the team. They have way too many threats, so I can't just focus one. Oh! Yep, that was on the Callista, okay. See you there, Callista. There, once again, for the 8th time or so, she's split pushing on her own. Even if it's mid and I'm nearby, she's way too far up, and I don't understand why she keeps doing that. It's a very simple solution that a lot of people don't seem to understand. It's just don't split push alone as an AD carry when there's an assassin on their team like that. And Callista keeps doing it, and I really don't want to, sound rude or anything like that by, pointing out these mistakes. It's just such a common mistake that a lot of people do. And I'm just hopefully, enlightening people that, learn from your mistakes, that's all. I will probably die because that was able to hit me. I will try my best to live here, but I am probably gonna die. Yes, I am. That will be my death. I'm assuming they had that jungle ward, because I'm finding it weird that they were actually able to remember where I was. Because I don't think shrooms give vision anymore. And that's all because of these. Careful. You'll die from, like, ugly lance in the E. Alright. At least she won't die. So, that's good. They're keeping daging. They should probably stop. Wait, we do have the Azir turret. Never mind. I keep thinking that Azir turret's not ours for some reason. And that will be all the flash. Q from the Warwick. Not going to be a kill. Now the Azir's flashing. They're really desperate for that kill, but it probably just will not come to fruition. So that's going to be Blitzcrank gaining a kill now. Not very good things occurring within this world. Warwick did kill the Blitzcrank, though, and the constant Isle should allow him to kill him relatively easily. Does Warwick have Bork? No, he doesn't. He just went Windsend, which is concerning. Personally, I think Bork is a item that is extremely useful on Warwick. I know Windsend's also very good, but, you know, I'm just saying. So, boop, boop, do a lot of damages here, and that will be that. They, Teemo... Did Kalista actually chase that when she had no health? Because that doesn't seem like a very good call. You know what, I'll let Warwick have that. Warwick's like the person I can rely most on this team, I think. I don't know, honestly, who I can rely on, who I can't rely on. I'm gonna still get red buff for myself, even though Warwick would be good with it. I am gonna see if I can do anything to this Lulu here, so we're gonna go on and head over here, and that will be a lot of damage, and this will be the ignite, but then flipping knockup is too strong. So that will be her living, and I, you know, I will go in on you, Lulu. Don't think I won't. But I probably shouldn't have used my ignite there. The overgrowth knockup is just too strong. So sadly, I wasn't really able to do a whole lot there. At least it'll get her to maybe, you know, go have to go back. She'll have to spend some time doing that stuff. Teemo did go a tank item now. Boop, boop. Ah, dang, I keep forgetting to get the sweeper lens. That's my fault. Maybe. Maybe. He's gonna get slowed down. That Q did not hit, though, and so that will be the end of that, and that's a Talon. Alright. Wasn't expecting the Talon. He's rather fed. I wonder who fed him, guys. Aha! Jokes. Dragon is gonna be theirs, because I am dead. Granted, even if I was alive, I'm pretty sure it would be theirs regardless. I mean, this is one of those games where it's like, I've done as much as I can. I've done as much as I can as a Shaco player. I ganked a lot in the game. I tried to get as much kills early as possible. I mean, I didn't gank bot a whole lot, but at the end of the day, you're supposed to just gank the easiest targets you can as Shaco and get kills that way. And I did succeed in that regard, but... And Kalista, they didn't even lose in lane. Kalista just keeps dying to the Talon now. And I just don't think there's anything I could have done to prevent the state of the game that we're currently in. And I don't think there's anything I could do to necessarily bring it back to a state where we can win it, but, you know, you never know. It's possible. I don't think it's, you know, likely, but I think it is possible. Kalista, though, will be dying once again. Not in a very good position, but that's okay. Let's just go ahead and not die here, if at all possible, though it's very possible. I don't like this, I'm not gonna lie to you. I should be a little bit careful if at all possible. Let's just not take any chances of dying there, and that'll be the end of that. Talon does hurt quite a bit, I'm not going to lie to you. Ooh, the pull not going to be in range. Azir might get a triple kill here. Never mind, he will die. But hey, he tried his best. They are going to kill that individual now, which is good. Now we'll just go ahead and kill that Kog'Maw, who got a little bit too close for his comfort. And I'm pretty sure Blitzcrank will not live. His mana barrier was in back down. Rest in peace, my good friend. You will be missed. Okay. If we can... I mean, I pretty much need to kill the Talon for us to have a chance to win these fights. But again, it's one of those situations where they have too many threats. And Shaco's extremely good at taking out one threat. But beyond that, he really just can't do anything. I mean, that's a lot of assassins in a nutshell. Which is why assassins aren't exactly... you know, highly praised in, like, you know, a higher play, because you can't really do much beyond killing one target. In a situation like this, where there's many threats that the rest of your team can't really take out well, that's a big issue. I'm definitely gonna try to take this, and that will be it for me. It looks like she saw me, but hey, at least I still got the Rift Scuttler. Not necessarily that valuable, but to be fair, Baron's gonna be up relatively soon, and we want to kind of be prepared for that. Okay. I can't do much there. That will be a death on the Azir. Ah, dear. This Talon, though, he's just destroying our entire humanity. What the heck? Well, they know where I am. Did I ever mention I don't like Teemo? Because I do not like Teemo very much. Alright, that'll be the end of the game, I guess. Warwick might get a kill here, but their entire team's alive. Azir is saying yes. I agree completely, Azir. Yes is a very good way to describe this game in a nutshell. This entire game is pretty much yes. And you know what, Warwick? I appreciate your efforts, at least you're trying. But you just have to accept the fact that, you know, oh wait, and he is stalling. We might actually not lose here. I mean, he has to go for Last Whisper next. Maybe I should go Tank Iron, but I don't think it's going to help much at this point. So I'm just going to keep going all-out Assassin mode. So that's going to be multiple of them dead. Baron is definitely what we should do now. So I'm going to ping it. And hope our team doesn't die. Though it looks possible. They were able to kill the Blitzcrank. And the Warwick is unstoppable now. He also has Thornmail. Well, they should kill him at least. Teemo got a double kill. Alright, that took a while. Teemo is quite the spooky individual by the looks of it. Teemo jungle is just too strong for them. He did get two items and he's going damage I am last, but now we definitely cannot get the Baron. That was our, you know, we had a chance there. But, you know, that chance is over, so let's do some damages to you and Hydro Proc to finish that off. By Hydro Proc, I mean, you know, not finish it off, but do a lot of damage, and that's good enough for me. Diamond plays. I guess that was a diamond play, Azir, if you say so. Oh, yes, the Shaco clones. One thing I haven't really done much of this game is utilize my clones well, but I feel like that's been much situations where I have been able to, because I just die even if I have my clone up, and it's just too spooky for me. But that's okay. Let's go get our red buff. Still have a chance at winning. We can turn this around. But it pretty much entirely revolves around if Talon is able to assassinate someone easily, which is pretty likely that he will. Another thing, Azir not having his Zonias is very surprising that he's chosen not to get one. I'm going to get this really quickly before I work on the Baron. So that will be the red buff for me, and now I will consider helping with this Baron buff. I'm definitely not going to start it, because that would be a silly idea. Got him relatively low. Don't know where Talon is. Ooh, that was good though. Good catching people out. Still wanna be wary of where this Talon is and where, what the heck? What the, oh jeez. Teemo was just destroying us. I was like, where's this damage coming from? God, I did like nothing useful that fight. That was, oh my. I just died there. I didn't even do anything that fight. Gran, I still think I could have done much. Even if I, like, went in on one of them, or if I escaped. But they're gonna try to live here. But it's probably gonna be the end of the game. I don't think there's much we could have done to win there, regardless. I mean, it comes down to the fact that I got fed early game as Shaco, but I just couldn't do anything in the late game phase, because no one else was strong enough. And I've been, you know, hammering this and saying it a lot, but that's simply the case. So that will be the end of the game. And Teemo jungle actually became quite the force as well. Alright, well, thankfully the game ended anyway.
Had to deal with the scumbags dragging the game on.
Ah, well, you know, this is like the Mordekaiser game in some stretching.
This Mordekaiser game in some aspects, it happens, but still demonstrates the power of Shaco and his early game potential, which at the end of the day, you know, that's what you're looking for with Shaco, so hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did like it, comment if it anything fantastic to say. I'll be sure to read it and subscribe if you haven't already. It's a warm present in my heart. Thank you and have a great day.